These are the topics covered in this video. Preparing the tree. Selecting the branches to graft. Grafting techniques. Results after 4 months. Developing fruits after 4 to 6 months. Pruning the grafts. Preparing the tree. A friend asked me to graft a new fig variety to one of his fig trees. Since we will be grafting an established tree, we need to cut most of the existing branches. Otherwise, the grafts will face too much competition and they might dry out, since most of the sap flow will be directed to the old branches. Using a small electric chainsaw, I removed most of the old branches. Choosing the branches to graft. I removed branches that were too thin or too large in diameter, as these were not good candidates for a graft. I am preserving one of the three main branches, since my friend doesn't want to completely remove the old variety. This is how the tree looks like before and after pruning. I preserved one of the three main scaffolds and removed all the other ones. This is how the tree looks with the grafts of the new variety after 4 months. Since I have 4 scions of the new variety to graft, I left 4 well-placed branches with a suitable diameter for the grafting technique I will be using. Grafting techniques. To graft the first scion, I chose to use the modified cleft graft. After cutting 2/3 of the branch with the pruning shear, I made a vertical cut near one of the edges of the branch. Avoid using too much force and let a sharp grafting knife do all the work. A gentle rocking motion works well for this type of cut. When grafting figs, the scion cut should be a bit shorter than needed at first. Fig scions have a hollow white interior. Make sure the final cut on the scion has a green area all around. Make a small angled cut on the other side of the scion. When the final scion cuts are done, you can then adjust the depth of the cut in the rootstock branch if needed. Place the scion on the cut, pressing firmly, until the back cut adjusts snugly to the rootstock. If the scion doesn't completely cover the cut width, place it to one side. The sides of the rootstock and scion should cross at some point. Make sure the top of the scion cut is slightly above the rootstock. Use tape to secure the scion firmly against the rootstock. Always start wrapping at the top of the graft, so the scion doesn't move when you apply pressure. Sometimes the cut in the scion might end up with a slight curve in the middle. That's not a problem, since when applying pressure with the tape, the tissues will adjust perfectly. Cover all areas of the graft and don't leave any gaps in the tape. You can also use parafilm, a wax-based tape, to cover the scion. This is not absolutely essential, but I like to use it, since it helps to keep the scion inner moisture. Grafting the second scion. also using the modified cleft graft. This technique is one of my favorites since it has a very high percentage of success and it works very well when the scion is of a smaller diameter than the rootstock. The cleft graft is also a very good option and will also work in this situation. Nevertheless, when using the cleft graft with smaller diameter scions, you usually will have to use two scions to completely fill the cleft cut. By cutting near an edge, the modified cleft graft uses only one scion and the end result is a much more balanced graft. The modified cleft graft has also an additional cambium contact point provided by the back cut at the bottom. While the cleft graft only makes contact with a very narrow strip of cambium in one of the sides of the scion. Grafting the third scion using the whip and tongue technique. Start by making a bevel cut in the rootstock branch. If you need to correct the cut, make sure it's completely straight. Make an identical cut in the scion. Check if the cuts have the same length and adjust them if needed. Measure the half point of the bevel cut and make a new cut to form the tongue, starting above that line. Be very gentle with the knife and insert it slowly, making a parallel cut just below the bevel. Make an identical cut in the scion. Anchor your fingers to the scion to control the knife. This will prevent the knife to move suddenly and will avoid the risk of injuries. Open the cuts and insert the scion until it adjusts firmly. Don't overlap the cuts at both ends. Start wrapping the graft with tape. Always start at the bottom, applying enough pressure to ensure the tissues make a good contact. I also use the same technique to graft the fourth scion. Fixed scions can be a bit curved. So they don't always adjust perfectly to the rootstock. Make sure the cuts are straight without undulating areas. If the surfaces of both cuts adjust well and the cambium layers cross at a few points, the graft will always work. Be careful when applying the tape. Avoid using too much pressure or the scion might move or break. I prefer to use this technique when the scions have a similar diameter, since it almost guarantees 100% graft success if well executed, as it has many cambium contact points. Protecting the grafts against bad weather. I am grafting in early spring, when the rootstocks start to wake up, using dormant scions. I like to use a padded envelope on each graft for extra protection. A few days of unpredictable bad weather with extreme cold or hotter temperatures than usual can compromise the chances of good graft healing, particularly in the first couple of weeks. A padded envelope keeps the scion in a stable environment until it has a chance to heal properly. Since water damage is one of the main reasons for graft failure, this approach increases the chances of graft success. Don't forget to identify the grafted variety and include the date of the graft. Results: after 4 months. After 3 or 4 weeks, the grafts start growing a few leaves. I start by making a small opening, and if I see leaves, I open the envelope completely. Supported by an established tree, the grafted branches grow very vigorously. This is how the grafts look after 4 months. I tend to use the modified cleft graft when the scions have a smaller diameter than the rootstock. It has a very high percentage of success and provides a strong union. Nevertheless, all the grafts should be supported in the first 3 months, or they might break under strong winds. I use the whip and tank technique when the scions have the same diameter as the rootstock branches. This type of graft has multiple cambium contact points, so it is almost foolproof when well executed. It also provides one of the strongest unions of all the grafting techniques. All the grafted branches show figs in various stages of development. Developing fruits after 4 to 6 months. In July, 4 months after the grafts, the young fruits are developing nicely. In August, some of the fruits are mature enough to harvest. It's a delicious variety. This type of fig keeps producing until late September. However, when conditions are difficult, the tree can drop its leaves. This happened this year, and the remaining fruits stop developing and will not mature. Pruning the grafts while the tree is dormant. This variety is very vigorous. In order to maintain the branches at a reasonable height, so fruits can be harvested without a ladder, it's best to have the main grafted branches. This should be done when the tree is dormant. In my zone, I'm doing it in the month of December. Make the cuts above, that is pointing towards the direction you want the new branches to grow. This way, the lower buds will produce secondary branches, increasing production and maintaining the fruits at arm's reach. The grafts after pruning. Conclusion: since the old variety has a very low quality, my friend asked me to graft the old branches with other good varieties. So, we also pruned some branches of the old variety to prepare for next spring grafting. This fig tree will end up with 3 or 4 different varieties of figs grafted on different branches. This way, with a single tree, we can test different fruit varieties. Additionally, if you graft varieties that don't mature at the same time, you can also expand the harvesting season. These videos require lots of time and effort to make. Show me your appreciation by liking the video and leaving a comment. Share the video, and if you haven't already, consider subscribing the channel to help me make more videos. Good luck with your grafting. Thanks for watching.